So this is a regular polygon. Kasi kapag all angles and all sides are congruent. Okay, this is our topic, kinds of polygons. So what is a polygon? It is a closed plane figure formed by connecting three or more segments at their endpoints. It's called polygons. So merong tatlo or apat or more segments at their endpoints na nag-connect siya bawat isa. Okay? So this is three segments nag-connect siya sa kanilang endpoint. Ang tawag nito ay polygon. Same with the same second figure. This is a square. Nag-connect din yung endpoints nila. This is four-sided polygon. Okay? So, ito ay six-sided polygon. Okay? So, these are the examples of a regular polygon. Masasabi natin regular polygon when all sides and all angles of a polygon are congruent. The polygon is a regular polygon or n-gon. So, ibig sabihin, kapag the same or congruent yung sides ng polygon, at saka yung angles nila ay congruent din, so this polygon is a regular polygon. So, if this is 5 cm, 5 cm, 5 cm, so congruent yung side nila. Then, of course, itong yung angle nila ay also congruent din yan. So, this is the equiangular triangle. At the same time, it is equilateral. It is because same congruent yung three sides. Okay? I-explain ko yan sa next topic pa. Okay, second figure, the same din yung congruent din yung sides nila. This is 4 cm. Lahat ng size ay 4 cm. Of course, yung angles nila ay congruent din. This is form right angles. So, right angles are congruent. Okay? So, this is a regular polygon. Kasi, kapag all angles and all sides are congruent. Okay? Another one, this is a hexagon because six-sided yan. Six. Okay? So, kapag congruent yung side nila, this is 2 cm, 2 cm, 2 cm, 2 cm, congruent yung side nila. At the same time, congruent din yung angles. This is 120, 120, 120, 120. So, the polygon is a regular polygon because all sides, lahat ng sides, at lahat ng angles ay congruent. Okay? Okay, next, we have the polygons are classified according to the number of sides. Okay? So, if the polygons is a three-sided polygon, the polygon is a triangle. So, sa triangle, marami ding mga kinds of triangle. So, i-discuss din natin yan sa susunod ng mga topics. Another one is four-sided polygon. So, the polygon is a quadrilateral. Okay, example ng mga quadrilateral, square, rhombus, rectangle, etc., etc. Marami ding mga kinds of quadrilateral. I-explain ko din yan, ha, sa susunod ng mga topics natin. Number five, or next, hindi siya number five, next pala. So, number of sides niya is five-sided polygon. So, the polygon is a pentagon. Okay, pentagon ang tawag kapag five-sided polygon na. So, kapag six sides, ang tawag niyan is hexagon. Seven sides, heptagon. Kapag eight-sided polygon, that is octagon. Okay? So, another one, if nine sides or nine-sided polygon, the polygon is a nonagon. Next, we have 10 sides, the polygon is decagon. Next is 11-sided polygon, that is undecagon. Okay? And number 12, or 12-sided polygon, kabungkagon, dodecagon. Okay? Dodecagon yung 12-sided polygon. And sides, ibig sabihin, pwede pa siyang 13, 14, 15, etc., etc. Ang tawag natin dyan, buugon o buugon, n-gon. Okay? N-gon ang tawag natin dyan. Next, polygons are also classified as convex or non-convex or concave. Okay? A polygon is a convex if the segment joining any two points on the polygon lies completely inside the polygon. So, yan ang tawag ay convex. Otherwise, the polygon is non-convex. Ano ba itong convex, non yan, non? Non-convex or concave. Okay, so example lang ng convex. Sabi sa convex, if the segment joining any two points on the polygon lies completely inside the polygon, so dapat yung segment niya ay nasa loob ng polygon. This is figure number one. This is a convex polygon. Kasi nasa loob yung segment niya. Okay? Any two points sa loob ng polygon. So this is a convex polygon. What about figure number 2? So, figure number 2 is also a convex polygon kasi yung segment niya ay nasa loob ng polygon. Okay, hindi siya pwedeng lalabas. Kung lalabas na yan, ay hindi na siya matatawag na convex polygon. Okay? Kasi completely, asan yun? Completely inside the polygon. Okay, so dapat nasa loob lang ng polygon yung kanyang segment. Tawag yan, convex polygon. Okay, another one, figure number 3. So, nasa labas na yung diagonal, yung segment niya. Sorry ha, hindi siya na diagonal. Iba yung diagonal. Nasa labas na yung segments. Okay, so this is a concave or non-convex polygon. Naiintindihan? Okay. Okay, next we have interior angle of a polygon is an angle on the inside of a polygon formed by its pair of adjacent sides. So this is the example of interior angles. Ayan, yung mga interior angle. Ayan, mga interior angle yan. Okay, so meron siyang pair of adjacent sides. It's because ito yung common side nila, ito yung common side and a common vertex. Kaya tinatawag ito na pair of adjacent sides. Merong mga adjacent sides dito, ha? Okay? Ayan. So, this is the example of interior angle. Ngayon, let's proceed to central angle. It's an angle formed by a segments joining consecutive vertices. Ibig sabihin, consecutive, ibig sabihin, kasunod. Okay? Sunod-sunod. Okay? So, consecutive vertices on the center to the center of a regular polygon. Okay, ito yung center of a polygon. So, dapat nag-join siya consecutive vertices. Yan. First vertices, then the second vertex. Okay, first na vertex and second vertex. So, dapat magkasunod. Pag hindi na siya magkasunod, hindi na itatawag na central angle. Dapat ang central angle, dalawang vertex na nagkasunod. Okay? Nag-join siya to the center of a polygon. So, ang tawag nito, central angle. Okay, nakuha? Okay, next, we have exterior angle. Exterior angle is an angle formed by a side and an extension of an adjacent side of the regular angle. Okay? So, this is the example of the exterior angle. Ito. Ayan, this is the exterior angle. So, di ba, meron siya extension of the adjacent side. Okay, so, exterior angle yan. Another one is the diagonal of a polygon. Diagonal of a polygon is a segment joining two non-consecutive vertices. Again, if you say non-consecutive, hindi magkasunod-sunod. Okay? Na vertices of a convex polygon. So, dito sa ating polygon na quadrilateral, merong isang diagonal. Bakit siya tinatawag na diagonal? Kasi merong non-consecutive vertices. Ang magkasunod dito dapat, di ba? Halimbawa, this is vertex A, B, C, D. Ang magkasunod, si B at saka si C. Si, di ba? Point B at saka si point C. Yun ang consecutive. Pero, dito sa ating diagonal, dapat hindi sila magkasunod. So, ibig sabihin, si A, point A, at saka si point C. Yun ang diagonal.
merong isang vertex na hindi siya na-connect. Dapat hindi magkasunod or non-consecutive vertices of a convex polygon. So itong tawag na to, itong line na to is a diagonal of a polygon or a regular polygon.
At maraming maraming salamat sa panonood. At kung hindi ka pa nakapag-subscribe sa channel ko, mag-subscribe ka na at i-hit mo yung notification bell para updated ka sa lahat ng mga videos na i-upload ko. See you in my next video. Bye-bye! Next video.